Now let's talk about an alternative model for structuring server applications that perform concurrent processing. The model we'll talk about is called event-driven model. An event-driven application can be characterized as follows. The application is implemented in a single address space. There is basically only a single process and a single thread of control. Here is the illustration of this model, and this is taken from Vivek Pai's flash paper as well. The main part of the process is an event dispatcher that continuously, in a loop, looks for incoming events, and then based on those events, invokes one or more of the registered handlers. Here, events correspond to some of the following things. Receipt of a request from the client browsers, that message that's received from the network, that's an event. Completion of a send, so once the server responds to the client request, the fact that the send completed, that's another event as far as the system is concerned. Completion of a disk read operation, that's another event that the system will need to know how to handle. The dispatcher has the ability to accept any of these types of notifications, and then based on the notification type, to invoke the appropriate handler. So in that sense, it operates very much like a state machine. Since we're talking about a single-threaded process, invoking a handler simply means that we will jump to the appropriate location in the process's address space where the handler is implemented. At that point, the handler execution can start. For instance, if the process is notified that there is a pending connection request on the network port that it uses, the dispatcher will pass that event to the accept connection handler. If the event is a receipt of a data of message on an already established connection, then the event dispatcher will pass that to the read request handler. Once the file name is extracted from the request and it's confirmed that the file is present, the process will send out chunks of the file, and then once there is a confirmation that that chunk of the file, portion of the file has been successfully sent, then it will continue iterating over the handler that's dealing with the send operation. If the file is not there, then some sort of error message will be sent to the client. So whenever an event occurs, the handlers are the sequence of code that executes in response to these events. The key feature of the handlers is that they run to completion. If a handler needs to perform a blocking operation, it will initiate the blocking operation, and then it will immediately pass control back to the event dispatcher, so will no longer be in the handler. At that point, the dispatcher is free to service other events or call other handlers.